This video will cover how to use the paid content block to accept one-time, monthly, or annual payments in exchange for access to things like a full recipe, training videos, a membership-only area, or even premium image galleries. We will show you how to set it up with exclusive content so that you can start earning money on your website. Before adding a paid content block, connect your site to Stripe to accept payments. This allows you to accept payments directly on your site. Stripe is a safe and secure payment processing platform trusted by millions of websites selling online. Connecting to Stripe is essential because it handles the checkout process, including collecting payments and transferring funds to your bank account. To set it up, you'll need to provide some personal information like your full name, date of birth, address, and a bank account where payments can be deposited. Stripe may also ask for a form of ID to verify your identity. To connect your Stripe account, go to your site's dashboard and navigate to Tools and click Monetize. Please note, if you're using the classic WordPress dashboard, you will find Monetize below Jetpack. And once you're on the Monetize page, you can click on Connect a Stripe account to collect payments. You'll be redirected to Stripe to sign in or create a new account. So once your Stripe account is connected, you can start adding paid content blocks and earning money from exclusive content. To add content that only your paying subscribers can see, follow these steps. Go to your WordPress dashboard, and then it depends on where you want to offer your exclusive content. If you want to add it to a post, make your way to Posts, top left, click All Posts, and then you can add a new post at the top. Or you can make your way to Appearance, click Editor, and this will open the site editor. Then you can make your way to Pages in the left sidebar. You can click Add Page to create a new page, or in this case, I've already created a page. Click on the preview screen on the right to open the page. And in this example, you will notice I'm selling practice tests and exams. To add a block, click on the plus icon top left, or in this case, we are going to use the shortcut and type /, and the name of the block. In this case, paid content, and then insert the block. Now, after you add a paid content block, you still need to assign a payment plan to it. A payment plan is where you will set your price, how often you want subscribers to pay, and other details. First, open the list view top left and ensure you have selected the paid content block. And then open your sidebar settings top right. Below Add a New Subscription, you can create your new payment plan. Make sure you name it appropriately, as this is the name that will appear in the email receipt your customers receive. Below that, you can choose the currency in which the payment will be collected. You can set the amount for the payment. You can also choose the interval or frequency at which your subscribers are billed. This can be monthly, yearly, or a one-time payment. In this case, it is a one-time payment. You can also allow customers to pick their own amount if you wish to. And then finally, click the Add Subscription button. And in the block toolbar, you will notice that the payment plan that we just created was assigned to the paid content block we added. Remember that a single paid content block can have just one subscription selected. So you would need to insert a paid content block for each payment plan or subscription level. Next, let's discuss the subscriber view and guest view. You will configure two views for your content, the view for paying subscribers and the view for guests who have not yet subscribed. Let's start with the subscriber view. This is where you will add the content your subscribers are paying for. Open the list view top left, select the paid content block, and then click subscriber view. At the bottom of the page below subscriber content, you will see it says add content here that will only be visible to your subscribers. So this is where you can add any content you want to appear for subscribers only, such as text, images, videos, etc. In this example, I'm going to add links to exam papers and answers. You can link your text to external platforms like Google Drive, but in this case, I've uploaded my exam papers and answer sheets to the media library and link to them directly from there. To do that, you can select the text, click the Add Link button in your block toolbar, make your way to the media library, open the dock, and then click Copy URL to Clipboard on the right. Return to the subscriber view and then paste the URL. And now all this content will be available to my subscribers. Visitors without access to the subscription will see what you add to the guest view. You can use this area to showcase a teaser of your paid content and explain the benefits of subscribing. In your list view, close the subscriber view and then select guest view. And below subscribe to get access, it says read more of this content when you subscribe today. We can replace this with our own content. I've decided to add some sample exams and reasons why I think it's important for visitors to subscribe. Also note, by default, you should see the subscribe and login buttons. These buttons allow your visitors to subscribe to the content or log into their account if they are already subscribed. To make sure your content is working correctly, open your site in an incognito window or a different browser where you are not logged in. This lets you view your site just like a regular visitor would. Check that only the public preview content is visible and that the exclusive content is properly hidden behind the payment prompt. Please note, if you have a plugin-enabled site, the WordPress.com secure sign-on feature must be enabled for the paid content block to work as expected. You can access this setting by navigating to Jetpack, clicking Settings, and below the first tab, Security, scroll down to the bottom. The setting Let users log in with their WordPress.com account for quick secure access should be turned on. Lastly, fees are based on the WordPress.com plan you have and are calculated as a percentage of your revenue. In addition, Stripe also collects a small fee for each payment made to your Stripe account. So, this fee system allows you to offer payments with minimal upfront investment. As you collect more supporters, it may make sense to move to a higher plan to retain more revenue. With everything set up, you are ready to start sharing exclusive content and offer subscriptions.